Hello, future engineers, subscribers, viewers, and students. There is another video in Engineers in Progress, particularly on the topic lines and circuits. For the principles, equations, standard forms of equations of lines and circles, you may proceed to the previous slides where I discuss the concepts and formulas used therein for you to understand and follow the solutions here. So there are exercises in this video, and I also assign problems for you to do your part or share. So answer the following questions. First, find an equation of the line through 3, 2 with equal non-zero intercepts. Then B, find an equation of the line with the same x-intercept as the line 2x minus 9y equals 14 and the same slope as the line x minus y equals 21. The blue colored problem is assigned to your part, and this is the answer. The pink colored text. Then D, find an equation of the line through the line whose y-intercept is twice its x-intercept and is also 3 times its slope. E, find the equation of the tangent line to x squared plus y squared equals 289 at 8, 15. And F, find the equation of the tangent line to x squared plus y squared equals 841 at 20, 21. And again, this is your part, which is the same as the above. So for part A, the intercept form of equation of a line is x over A plus y over b equals 1, where a is the x-intercept and b is the y-intercept. Since x-intercept is equal to y-intercept, this is the intercept form of equation of a line. We replace b by a because a and b are equal as stated in the problem, and x and y are points on the line. One point would be 3, 2, which is given. So this is 3 over A plus 2 over A equals 1. So 5 over A equals 1. So that means A is 5. Therefore, the equation of the line is x over 5 plus y over 5 equals 1. I just put the answer that way, the intercept form, so that it is clear in this problem. Then B, find an equation of the line with the same x-intercept as the line 2x minus 9y equals 14 and the same slope as the line x minus y equals 21. So since the line has the same slope as this, the form of equation or answer would be x is in this form. The answer is x minus y equals x1 minus y1, where x1 and y1 are points on the line, and one point of that would be the x-intercept, of course the partner would be 0 because the point of intersection of this line with the x-axis as the coordinate x-intercept a, 0. So, first, for this line, let's transform this to intercept form by dividing everything by 14. So, we have 2x over 14 plus negative 9y over 14 equals 1. After we divide by 14, simplifying, that's x over 7 plus y over negative 14 over 9 equals 1. So, the x-intercept is 7 and the y-intercept is negative 14 over 9, but it's the x-intercept that is important. So a is 7, and take note that the partner of that is 0, intersection with the x-axis. So the expected equation is x minus y equals x1 minus y1. And since x1 is 7 and y1 is 0, so x minus y equals 7 minus 0. So therefore, the required line is x minus y equals 7. Then we proceed to part D, find an equation of the line whose y-intercept is twice its x-intercept and is also 3 times its slope. So we write the expected equation of the line, which is x over a plus y over b equals 1. And b is equal to 2a. B is equal to 2a because it is stated there that the y-intercept is twice its x-intercept. The x-intercept is a, so b is 2a. And this 2a here, the y-intercept, is also 3 times the slope of that line. So simplifying first, so 2a equals 3m as stated, so that means the slope is 2a over 3. And we multiply this equation here, expected equation, intercept form, by 2a, so it becomes 2x plus y equals 2a. So the slope is negative a over b, negative coefficient of x, which is 2, over coefficient of y, which is 1. So the slope is negative 2 over 1, or negative 2, and we equate that to this equation here. So m is negative 2, and equate it to 2a over 3. So that means a is negative 3. So if a is negative 3, then if a is negative 3, then that means 2a is negative 6. So substitute into that equation, x over negative 3 plus y over negative 6 equals 1. Then we multiply everything by negative 6. So the final answer is 2x plus y equals negative 6. So that's it for that part D. We proceed to part E. So the technique in algebra and in analytic geometry is that we replace x square by xx1 and y square by yy1, and also if we have x, then replace it by 1/2 quantity x plus x1 and y by 1/2 quantity y plus y1. So that's the technique in analgebra, but I will not use this, but the result in the explanation here would be similar to this, and in fact it's singular. So the circles have centers at the origin, and I already discussed distance from a point to a line. So distance from the center of the circle to the tangent, the line which is the tangent, and there is a point of tangency. And take note that the tangent line and the radius are perpendicular to each other. So for x square plus y square equals 17 square, 289 is 17 square. So the center is at the origin and the radius is 17. And let's have this sketch of the graph of the circle first as our guide, so that I can explain that the distance from a point to a line is equal to absolute value of ax1 plus by1 plus c over square root of a squared plus b squared. Now, the That's the distance from a point to a line. And for a circle with center at the origin, this distance is the radius, as shown in this figure here. So 17 equals ax a times 8 plus b times 15 plus c over square root of a square plus b square. So from the figure here, we have c is 0 for the radius, because the radius of the circle for this circle here passes to the origin. So it has no constant for its equation. By the way, this is the circle, and the point of tangency is at 8, 15. Then we have the tangent line as our guide and the radius. And take note that the radius and the tangent are perpendicular to each other. Since the center of the circle passes through the origin, then the radial line passes through the origin, so it has no constant. In fact, the slope of the radial line is opposite 15 over 8, because the origin is at 0, 0. So ax plus by plus c equals 0 for, let's consider the circle, that's the radius rather, and the radius has no constant because it no y-intercept, it passes through the origin, so we just set c 0 for that radius. So therefore, the slope of the line is negative coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y, so it is negative a over b. That's the slope of the line. In this case, it is also equal to 15. The slope of the line, this line tangent here, is negative a over b. It has a constant, but this is our guide. But for the radial line, the slope is simply 15 minus 0, which is 15, over 8 minus 0, which is 8. So the slope of the radial line is 15 over 8. And since the product of the slopes of perpendicular lines is negative 1, that means the slope of the tangent is the negative reciprocal of the slope of the radial line. So the slope of the radial line is 15 over 8. That means that the slope of the tangent line is negative reciprocal of 15 over 8, so it is negative 8 over 15. So substitute. So we have ax, a is 8, b is 15, so substitute into the formula above. So ax plus by equals ax1 plus by1. So a is 8, x1 is also 8, b is 15, and y1 is also 15. So 8x plus 15y equals 8 times 8 plus 15 times 15. Note that the right side is equal to 289, which is the radius square. So therefore, we have justified that this equation is correct, that we replace x by xx1, y by yy1. So if we substitute it directly into this equation, xx1 plus yy1 equals 289, or radius square, then we would have obtained the same answer, that is 8x plus 15y equals 289. So the alternate solution is replacing x by xx1 and y by yy1, and the right side is 289, or the constant or radius square, then we would have the same answer. 8x plus 15y equals 289. Therefore, based on this guide here, the part F can now be answered easily. So we do the same because the result is the same. We replace x by x, x1, x squared by x, x1, and y by y, y1. So x, x, x1 plus y, y plus y, y1 equals radius square for 841. So x1 is 20 and y1 is 21. So therefore, the answer is 20x plus 21y equals 841. So that's it. Then you can do the same procedure for your part in part 2.